بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، according to أهل السنة والجماعة، أبو بكر is a believer and the best man ever after the prophets and messengers. According to the 12er Shia جعفرية، أبو بكر is a kafir، استغفر الله، and the worst man ever. This is one of the most important creed of the 12er Shia religion. Creed in the sense of عقيدة، which means that to be called a Muslim by the Shia 12ers, you must believe that Abu Bakr is a kafir and you must hate him. Then of course, the rest of the 100,000 companions except 7, as they convey in their books, they justify their visceral hatred toward Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and the companions by claiming that Abu Bakr and the companions usurped the Khilafah from Ali and they oppressed Ahlul Bayt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا صدق الله العظيم. So in order to know who's right and who's wrong about Abu Bakr, we have to go back to the Quran. Let's prove from the Quran that Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه is a Muslim and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves him. I will be using Shia tafsir from the first and last centuries, tafsir which you can find online in the Shia website. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا والله عزيز حكيم. صدق الله العظيم. This verse of the Quran is doubtlessly the most hated verse by the Rawafid because it simply and quickly destroys their religion. The companion who was with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi in the cave is Abu Bakr. I don't need to prove it for the Sunnis, but here is the proof for the Shia who may have forgotten it. Shaykh al-Ta'ifa Abu Ja'far al-Tawsi in his Tafsir al-Tibyan said, quote, the second of two, which means that there is someone else with him and it is Abu Bakr when they were in the cave, unquote. Abu Ali al-Fadl ibn al-Hasan al-Tabarsi in his Tafsir Jawami' al-Jami', quote, ثاني اثنين, meaning one of two, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih and Abu Bakr, unquote. Tafsir Nur al-Thaqalain of Shaykh Abd Ali bin Jum'a al-Huwayzi. He quoted from Tafsir Ali ibn Ibrahim al-Qummi what follows: when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi was in the cave with Abu Bakr, etc. We can of course check this reference in Tafsir al-Qummi, which is available in this website. However, we can notice one curious thing, which is that al-Qummi refused to write down Abu Bakr's name and he called him Fulan instead. Al-Mawla Muhsin, also known as Al-Fayd al-Kashani in his Tafsir al-Safi, said, quote, the second of two, which means that there was only one man with him when they were in the cave of Thawr, which is a mountain in the east of Mecca, when he said to his companion, who is Abu Bakr, unquote. And now for some tahrif. As I said, this verse is a big problem for the Shia. And what do? When they have a problem with the Quran, they bring the tahrif argument. In the same tafsir, Al-Kashani quotes from another Shia tafsir, Tafsir Al-Iyashi, who narrated a hadith from the 8th Shia Imam Al-Ridha. Al-Iyashi says, he alayhi salam said, they, meaning the Sunnah, argue against us using the verse ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار, but they have no argument in it. I swear, in reality, Allah said, فأنزل الله سكينته على رسوله, and he, meaning Abu Bakr, wasn't mentioned in it in good. Someone said, is this how you recite it? He alayhi salam said, this is how I recite it. And in the narration, which is just above, narrated from Al-Kafi, he said, this is how we, the infallible Shia Imams, read it, and this is how it was revealed. And this is tahrif, because there is no ala rasulihi in the Quran. As-Sayyid Tabatabai in his Tafsir al-Mizan narrated a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, who said to Abi Bakr, you are my brother and my companion in the cave, and you are with me at the Hawd. And the last tafsir we picked is the tafsir of Ayatul Lat العظمى ناصر مكارم الشيرازي, who sounds like he doesn't know Arabic.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. إذا جاء نصر الله والفاتح.
In his tafsir, Al-Amthal fi tafsir kitab Allah al-Munazzal said, quote, however, he, meaning the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, headed towards the cave of Thawr, which is in the south of Mecca, and he hid there, and Abu Bakr was with him in this migration, unquote. To make a long story short, there is no Shia tafsir which denies that Abu Bakr was the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi in the cave. The Shia, as well as the Sunnah of course, believe that Abu Bakr was the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi in the cave. Now please, let's focus on the following part of the verse. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. First of all, I'm not going to use the Sahib argument, because the Shia will say that Sahib can be used for both Muslims and non-Muslims, which is correct, and they will probably quote the verse 39 of Surah Yusuf. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا صاحبي السجن أرباب متفرقون خير أم الله الواحد القهار صدق الله العظيم. No, what I'm going to use is the second part, إن الله معنا, for Allah is with us. Let's analyze this. First of all, who is saying it? Allah Azza wa Jal, of course, since it's a verse. But Allah Azza wa Jal is quoting his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi said it before when they were in the cave. Now what does this sentence say? إن الله معنا, for Allah is with us. Simply put, without any useless wandering or search for hidden meaning, Allah is with us means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also with Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. And this is what the Shia always forget or close their eyes about, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also with Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه. Again, we have two testimonies. The first was from the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وآله, bearing witness that Allah سبحانه وتعالى is with Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه. Can the Prophet be wrong? No. وما ينطق عن الهوى. The second, which came after, is from Allah سبحانه وتعالى, and it came to strengthen the first one. How? By confirming it in an eternal verse in the glorious Quran. This two testimonies bear witness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu. Now, can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with a kafir? No, wa'iyadu billah. In fact, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala informed us about whom he is with in the Quran. He, jalla jalaluhu, said, ba'da a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytani ar-rajim, inna allaha ma'a as-sabirin. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. سبحان الله. Did you hear that? Did you hear what Allah is telling you? And know that Allah is with المتقين, those who fear Him. وَاللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. In Surah Al-Anfal, Allah تبارك وتعالى addressed Abu Jahl and the Kuffar. He subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِن تَسْتَفْتِحُوا فَقَدْ جَاءَكُمُ الْفَتْحُ وَإِن تَنْتَهُوا فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَإِن تَعُودُوا نَعُدْ وَلَن تُغْنِيَ عَنْكُمْ فِئَتُكُمْ شَيْئًا وَلَوْ كَثُرَتْ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. وَاللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. In Surah At-Tawbah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He is with Abu Bakr, He Azza wa Jal said in two different verses, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. First conclusion, Abu Bakr is a Sabir, muttaqi, mu'min, and muhsin. And what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about these four types of pious believers? He subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدًّا. Second conclusion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. And finally, to definitively bury the Shia Rafida religion and to prove that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't put verses in the Quran just like that, and that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam really meant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with Abu Bakr and he wasn't just saying, and that the verse really meant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with Abu Bakr, here is what said Prophet Moses sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in circumstances extremely similar to when our Prophet was in the cave with Abu Bakr. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fled from Quraysh with his companion Abu Bakr. Prophet Musa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fled from Pharaoh with his companions from Banu Israel. Quraysh chased Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr in order to kill them. Pharaoh chased Musa and his companions in order to kill them. Both prophets with their companions were in a dead end. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the cave, and the Prophet Musa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stopped by the sea. The companions of both prophets got frightened and nervous when they saw the enemy getting close. The Qurayshi chasers arrived to the cave of Thawr, and they were at only few paces from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr. Quraysh was so close at that moment that Abu Bakr said, O Prophet of God, if one of them just bends his head down to his feet, he would see us. In the Quran, Allah said that Banu Israel said to Moses, فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَىٰ إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. We are sure to be overtaken. We already know the answer of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran. لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. Have no fear, for Allah is with us. But what was the answer of Prophet Musa to his companions? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the answer was, كَلَّا إِنَّ مَعْيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. By no means, my Lord is with me, he will guide me. Can you see the difference? Do you see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to understand? We know who Banu Israel are and what they did after. They worshipped the calf. They exhausted Musa and Harun alayhim as-salatu was-salam. They disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They corrupted the book. They failed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why from the very beginning Allah azza wa jal said that he was only with his prophet and not with them. قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. They said, we hear and we disobey. In contrast, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that he is with his prophet and that he is with the companion of his prophet, which means that unlike Banu Israel, Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obeyed his messenger, and that he pleased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. Conclusion: the Quran states that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with Abu Bakr and that Allah jalla jalaluh loves those he is with. The Shia Ja'fariya say Abu Bakr is a kafir, we hate him. You are saying that Allah is wrong. Wal'iyadu billah. Abu Bakr is the best companion ever. This is why he was the companion of the Prophet in the cave and he is his companion in the grave. As mentioned before, the Shia based their aqidah on the hatred and the takfir of Abu Bakr and the companions. Unfortunately for them, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala addressed the companions in the Quran and said, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ فَلَا تَهِنُوا وَتَدْعُوا إِلَى السِّلْمِ وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ وَاللَّهُ الله معكم ولن يترك أعمالكم. صدق الله العظيم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said that he is with the companions. The Shia say the companions are kuffar. We hate them. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said that he is with the companions. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala also said بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم. And at the end of the verse he عز وجل said ليغيظ بهم الكفار. صدق الله العظيم. So the Quran also says that those who hate the companions are the kuffar. Final conclusion, the foundations of the Shia Rafida religion are opposed to the Quran. And if the foundations of a building are destroyed, it's the whole building which collapses. Enough said. هذا وصل اللهم وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والحمد لله رب العالمين.